Next game coming your way, ladies and gentlemen, here in the stadium will be game number 5 in your bracket. It'll be a round number 2 ball game. It'll feature the team that won our opener, Taylor May, and the number 8 seed, Woodlaw. As is the case with all of the games here at the Major Conference Championship, the higher seeded team is the home team, so Woodlaw will be your home team. Their full name, Woodlaw Mizuno Famous Easton. They will be the home team. And their opponents, TaylorMade TM Sports Mizuno, will be the visitors.
Thank you. Atta boy!
tag with a nifty slide to the outside. So credit him with the inside, the park homer, it's a 1-0 game, and now into the box, the right fielder, number 17, Robert Blackburn. High fly ball to deep left from Blackburn, but the park holds it, and Matt Bunn gathers it in. So now two away, and stepping into the box, it'll be the middle infielder, Tevin Kennington. Tevin had a grand slam home run in Taylor Made's opener. They sit up the middle for Kevin Kennington. It's now one on with two outs, and stepping into the box, it'll be the third baseman, Herb Haywood. Fly ball to deep right field from Stacy Bolton, but a nice running catch by Jesse Harrison retires the side. TaylorMade picks up three runs here in the top of the first. They get those three runs on four hits. Two up. For Woodlaw, it'll be Hanson, Watson, and Strong.
Are you playing? Who's down? Okay.
Stepping into the box to lead things off for Woodlaw, it's the middle infielder, number 8, Chris Hansen. Hansen playing out of Las Vegas, Nevada. Watson, so one on, one out, and now stepping into the box, it'll be the shortstop, number 12, from Sherman, Texas, Dennis Schrum. So now they're loaded up for the first baseman, number 23 from Indianapolis, Indiana, Ryan Goins.
Come on. face.
Go hard, let's go, go hard! Lose that body! Let's go, kid, have the fun in here! Ain't no pressure here, let's go, we're here to hit, Mike!
Power, performance, and durability. The 2011 DeMarini lineup is ready to take the slow pitch world by storm. With game-changing barrel technology like N-Spec and 4-1 composite, or the incredibly responsive feel of the SC4 alloy handle, the GTL Cartel, Stadium, and 112 have what you need to take your game to the next level. Step up to the plate with players like Chris Larson, Gino Buck, and Kevin Philby, and take your place in the DeMarini Slow Pitch Nation. DeMarini, insane dedication to performance.
goes up. Steve Whaley's single with a double to right. Runners at second and third, nobody out. And into the box, it'll be the center fielder, number 7, Adam Elliott.
Kevin Rye at the plate. Sorry, a little shorter of a crew today, so we're trying to get some lunch taken care of and some dinner all at the same time. 4-1 Taylor made in the lead over Woodlaw, Mizuno famous Easton.
Come on, Rob.
Got under that one. And it's going to be caught. They'll tag and score a run, the fifth of the ball game.
So the high fly ball in the shallow left field, a tough running catch. And Rye alertly tags and scores. So Credit Blackburn with an RBI sacrifice fly. One out, bases cleared, and in the box, the middle infielder, Kevin Kennington.
And now Kevin coming to the plate here in the third inning. Long and gone. There's a home run. 6-1. Taylor Mead is on top. That's a gapper. He's going to have a chance to score the seventh run of the ball game. And it will. 7-1.
And Bailey hustling in, beats the relay throw. Credit Holton with an RBI double. It's a three-run inning. It's a 7-1 lead. Two outs, and now in the box, the left-handed hitting left fielder, Jeremy Yates.
Grounded to first. It's a race to the bank. They'll tag the bag in time. And that retires the side.
And the ground ball got hit by Collins. He takes it himself. That retires the side.
My name's Lee Powers. I'm 26 from Gaston, North Carolina. I've been playing softball since 2003. Last year was my first year playing in the conference, and I played with Gene Shop TPS. I've always been around Louisville Slugger. My dad played Louisville Slugger base his whole career. In 2001, they won the Grand Slam. They won all four worlds, the long haul. They got out of the game a little bit, but Louisville Slugger's got great bats now, they're coming back. My dad played with Louisville Slugger, and now that I'm playing with it, it means a lot to me. I've been swinging Louisville Slugger since I started swinging a bat. I swing the Z1000 because it's hot out the Raptors, got a great sweet spot, and I've always swung a one piece, and it doesn't feel like a two-piece. With the Z1000, Louisville Sluggers came a long ways in the slow pitch game.
Louisville Slugger, TPS, we're back.
Second base hit of the ball game, and now stepping into the box will be the shortstop, number 12, Dennis Schrum.
Dennis Schrum now. Hit that one well, but foul. To left and off the left field wall. That's extra bases.
And that's an RBI triple for Dennis Schrum.
And Woodlaw
two extra base hits
scores
the
just
game.
Their second run of this ball game. And it's 7-2. Blasted well. This one is going to score the third run of the ball game.
RBI double for Hickenbotham. Schrum into score at 7-3. Still nobody out. And now in the box, the first baseman, Brian Goins.
Brian Goins now in a 7-3 ball game. We haven't seen it be much of an advantage so far, being the home team. Maybe Woodlaw can use that advantage of having the hammer to work their way back in this ball game. What a stop.
Goins with the hot
the other will tag the bag
nice
at first for the first out of the inning. Goins is retired.
Hitting about the third down, one out for the third baseman, Frank Yelding.
Frank Yelding. Down the right field line, it's 7-4.
Right for Yelding, and the score is Hickenbotham. That makes it seven to four, still only one
picks
out.
Picks up the run batted in.
To the box. It'll be the second
a three-run ball game.
From Hurst, Texas, Steve Whalen.
First two pitches miss. This one swung on and it's going to tail the opposite way and it falls for a hit. Completely misplayed ball there.
Up Matt Bunn. Matt doubled in his first at bat.
Performance and durability. The 2011 DeMarini lineup is ready to take the slow pitch world by storm. With game-changing barrel technology like N-Spect and 4-1 composite, or the incredibly responsive feel of the SC4 alloy handle, the GTL Cartel Stadium and 112 have what you need to take your game to the next level. Step up to the plate with players like Chris Larson, Gino Buck, and Kevin Philby, and take your place in the DeMarini Slow Pitch Nation. DeMarini, insane dedication to performance.
It's a 15-11 ball game as we open up action here in the fourth.
And fly ball to left field by Brian Logan. There's one away.
There's a fly out for the first out of the inning. Opposite field and into the stands. Sun setting on a perfect day for slow pitch softball here. We're glad you decided to join us wherever you are. Coverage begins tomorrow morning at 9:30 a.m. Of course, mark your calendar if you want to know who won the conference awards. Those will be handed out tomorrow night. Ceremony starting around 7 o'clock Eastern time. We'll have it for you live on USSALive.com. These games brought to you in high definition by Louisville Slugger. Popped up and caught for the second out of the inning.
Fly ball to center field. There gathered is Elder Jones retired. Now over to the top of the order for Eli Aguilar.
Taylor Maiden Woodlaw here. In a tight ball game. Obviously, very important to stay on the winner's side of things. We have winner's bracket action for you tomorrow. There's another walk, and there's two aboard for Aguilar, who draws the walk. Now Ryan at the plate. Opposite way to right field. This one carry enough. Now the ballpark will hold it.
And a play made to
retire the side.
And so Taylor made.
We move on to the bottom of the fourth. Taylor made playing to a two-run advantage.
It'll be Harrison, Hanson, and Watson.
Hey, I'm doing up my hit bag.
Here's a leadoff walk to start off the bottom of the fourth inning.
So now we will go to the top of the order for Chris
Harrison getting aboard, and here's the extra fielder,
Chris Hanson,
0 for 2 in the ballgame.
conference action.
Line drive, base hit. And they're on the corners. Fans, reminder, log on to Facebook.com. Search USSA dash slow pitch softball. Here you'll find our Facebook page. That was nearly an inning-ending triple play. Holds it, and the inning over. Nearly a triple play in that one. But it's 7-5 as we head to the bottom of the fourth.
The ball picks up one run. At the end of four complete, it is a 7-6 game. Two up in the top of the fifth, it'll be Blackburn, Kennington, and Haywood.
As a leadoff hit, set up action here in the fifth.
And there's a base hit to right center field for Robert Blackburn to get things started. Now stepping to the box is the middle infielder, Kevin Kennington.
Seven to six, our score. Blackburn gets aboard. Here's Jonas. And unfortunately, the second time was not the charm. Popped up and it's fouled away for the first out of the inning. 7-6. Taylor Made on top of Woodlaw. And they got it through both that time for a base hit. And that's out number two. Taking a look at our bracket. Resmondo's going to take on the winner of this one next. So it could be the third game of the night for Taylor Made if they hold on to this result. Play made to retire the side.
And bolt flies out to
so Taylor Made able to score a run. 8-6. Our score.
One run on two hits.
As we head to the bottom of the fifth inning.
Bottom half. Do up. Higginbotham. Goins and Yeldon. Got a great crew on hand, bringing you the sights and sounds. This game also available on Point Streak Scoring. And another crew on the other side that is scoring this game on Point Streak. So be sure to click the button if you're watching us right now on your computer. The game is available in HD. Right underneath there's a link where you can bring up the scoreboard for today's games. And if you were there, you'd see that there's a home run
hit by Brian,
Higginbotham. Things jump started here in the bottom of the fifth.
He's now 4 for 5 in this ball game, and that's the second RBI he's picked up. And it's 8-7.
Is Brian Goins.
Goins pops it up. That's out number one.
A high fly ball to straightaway center field. Brian Logan gathers it in, one out. And now stepping into the box, the third baseman, number 31, Frank Yeldon.
Now Frank Yeldon to the plate. Later tonight, GTL Cartel DeMarini is going to take on either Dorflinger or Sonny's. A game happening out on field two.
They just cut them on now.
Right now, they're playing on a total of 3 fields. And then it'll extend over to Fortune Road for a B championship.
Second baseman,
as well. Got the best of the major, the A and the B here. Lights are on here at Osceola County Stadium, and there's a line out for out number 2 to Zwack.
Robo, push one time to ya.
All the bats tested prior to the game. And they're placed in a bucket, as you can see, behind home plate. Good group of family and friends gathering here. This one down the left field line. That's going to be a fair ball. Doug Wood coaching third.
Second and third with 2 outs, and it's an opportunity for number 7, Adam Elliott, to stake his game to a lead.
Go get it! That boy!
It's caught, and that retires the side. One run, Taylor made lead. They're so looking to take on Chris Mondo, who's on the ballpark next. Conference championship live on USSSALive.com.
Two innings to play, and it's anybody's ball game. Do up for TaylorMade as they come to bat with a one run lead. It'll be Yates, Logan, and Zwack.
Come on!
Hey, Jeremy, let's go. Pick me up.
Hey, bottom push to the top here. Let's go. Hold on. Come on, you guys. Let it go, boy. Let's go. Let it go, you guys. Let it go, you guys. Let's go, boy. Mo, Yang. Go to work, Yang.
Heads up, boys. I'm swinging. Get loose. Heads up.
Hitter. Hitter swinging.
I wanted one of my come behind.
Hitter swinging.
Oh, he takes off. Of the left-handed hitting left fielder, Jeremy Yates.
Oh, yeah, Jay.
And it's a solid single to right center field for Yates to get things started. But now stepping into the box, the scheduled hitter is Brian Logan. But it looks like number 28, Cheyenne Brooks, has got a bat in his hand. Looks like Brooks will bat in place of Logan.
Runner on first here in the sixth. Yates gets aboard. Logan, the center fielder, who's 0 for 2 at the plate. This is spring training, home of the Astros.
And that's a call strike, so one away, and it'll bring up the pitcher.
Call strike three. That's the first out on the scoreboard here in the top of the sixth. Tag the bag at second and get one, and they're going to get an inning-ending double play.
He touches the bag himself, fires to Gomans, and it's
so Taylor May blanked. Is this the moment
for
Woodlaw in the bottom of the sixth?
They have an 8-7
trailing by a run.
Due up in the bottom of the sixth for Woodlaw, it will be Harrison.
Well, Worth Brown's evolved quite a bit. I mean, when it was aluminum back when I first started, they had the best aluminum bat by far with the PST, and now they've...
off the right fielder, number 9, Jesse Harrison. And there's a high fly ball into shallow right field. A nice running grab made there by Kevin Rye. There's one out. And now stepping the box.
Woodlawn with a chance. They try to take the lead here in the bottom of the sixth and put TaylorMade down to their final three outs. Rounded into left field for a base hit.
And a solid single left for Anson. Tying run at first, there's one out, and in the box is L.C. Watson.
Certainly holds it, and that's the second out. Big moment for these teams. They'll take on Rismondo next on this field. Seven. That one down the line. If it stays fair, it's likely gone, and it just turned foul at the last
drive.
Of course, a reminder, we'll have men's major coverage as well for you. Coming out from Disney. Popped out to right field. That retires the side. Onward and upward we go. We head to the seventh in a one-run ball game. TaylorMade leading 8-7.
For TaylorMade, it'll be Jonas Aguilar Rye. Floyd, who hits a triple, he turns off. Floyd's been stellar in both of his pinch hitting appearances, and now we go to the top of the order for Eli Aguilar.
Seven, our score. It's 10-7. Looking to win back-to-back games and take on Rismondo. Grounded out, that retires the side. 10-7 our score. Woodlaw will need to score three to push us on to the eighth.
Ryan Higginbotham into the box. Higginbotham from aboard for the fourth time in the ballgame, this time a leadoff single. Now stepping in the first baseman, Brian Goins.
Down the line, there's a base hit. Good start for Woodlaw. They had the first two batters reach here in the bottom of the seventh inning. And Frank yielding now. The dock at the plate, 2-for-3. With an RBI. Popped up, and it's going to be caught for out number one.
So after Goins doubled, Frank Yeldon with the high pop fly. Haywood there gathered in, one out. Still representing the tying run at the plate, second baseman Steve Ware.
One away here in the bottom of the seventh.
Basically like you're stuck inside a burning house. Your body's inside your head and you're inside your body. You're completely fine. It's like you're getting
driven deep and off the wall. Nearly a game-tying home run. Instead, it'll be a one-run ball game. It's 10-9 with one away.
RBI triple for Steve Whaley. He chases into Higginbotham. Going to score. It's 10-9. The tying run 75 feet away. And stepping into the box, Matt Bunn.
Resmondo specialty tank. They're on the field next. Short, the throw to first, Bailey reached, and the tying run comes in. It's 10-10, and Woodlaw has a chance now to win it.
Elliott, the winning run now at second base, one out for Jesse Harrison.
10-10 ball game. Taylor Made needs two more outs. Go-ahead run on second. That's all that matters at this point with one away. This one cranked in the left field. Deep, back off the wall. It's caught. And the runners will move up to second and third.
Fly ball to left field. A nice running catch by Yates is deep enough for Bunn and Elliott to advance. So the scene set. Two on, two outs, game tied. Into the box, Chris Hansen.
Swung on into right. Woodlaw has done it. They come back from down three to win it 11-10.
L.C. Watson, the dramatic single to right.
So Woodlaw is on the field next against Resmondo. Stay with us.
Our
coverage conference,
UAAA,
the 2011 edition will continue right here on UAAALive.com.
So a super ball game here in the third game of the day in the stadium. Both teams play well. Woodlaw comes through in the bottom of the seventh. It's an 11-10 victory. For Woodlaw, they'll stay right here at the stadium. They'll play in the upcoming game where they will face off against the number one seed, Resmondo. For TaylorMade, they played two great games today. They won the first 11-9. They lose the second 11-10. Once again, the next game coming your way is game number 11 in your bracket. Game number 11. It is a round number 3 game. It'll feature the Woodlaw team we just saw pull out their dramatic victory, facing off against the number 1 seed.